So guys, recently I had made a video and a guide on how you could pass the strong integrity test using an unrevoked keybox XML file. But as was the concern, Google seems to have patched that unrevoked keybox XML file, because as of the time of recording, over 400 users asked for that file and have shared the file to them via email, and it came in the notice of Google and the XML file has now been patched. With that said, I have now found a new keybox XML file using which you could pass this test once again. So you could simply drop your comments in the email section. Do keep in mind that your email will be visible in the comment section. So keep in mind that send an email or the comment using an email which is not important from your point of view. So with that said, you could download the keybox XML file. I'll simply send you the link on your email. And as far as the instructions are concerned, I am already made a video and a guide, but still I'll show you once again how to use this XML file. So please take a backup of all the data on your phone, and do note that at the time of recording this video, which is 15th October, this keybox XML file is unrevoked, but it might be the case similar to the last one that Google might patch this file in the near future. So as of now it's working, and keeping that in mind, let me first show you my phone has obtained root by Magisk, but as of now it's failing all the three tests. As you could see, let me show the check once again. So now let's pass all these three tests using the unrevoked keybox XML file. So first and foremost, you will have to get hold of the following modules and a couple of apps as well. This is a root software file manager app. In this, you may use any app of your choice. I am using the solid file manager app because it supports root. Then you could also use the plain integrity API checker. This is required to check if your phone is passing the strong test or not. And apart from that, these are the modules. Likewise, your phone should also be using the Magisk Canary and not the Sable build. To update to Magisk Canary, I will link a guide and a video in the description. In short, just download the latest Magisk Canary build from the official GitHub page, then install the APK. Now update the app, then launch the Magisk app, tap on update, then select direct install, and Magisk will then be updated to the Canary build. The Canary version is required for the Shamico module. The Shamico will not work in the stable or beta build. So make sure to update your Magisk to the Canary version. I am again repeating, although I will link the guide and the video in the description, but in short, you just have to get hold of the latest Canary APK from GitHub, install the APK, tap on update next to Magisk, choose direct install, and that's it. So with this, you will now be in the Canary build. Once that is done, download the Shamico module, LS4 framework, Play Integrity, Zygisk Assistant, and Tricky Store from here. Once you have got all these modules, you will not have to flash these modules. So let's get the job done as well. So launch the Magisk app, go to modules, tap on install from storage. First off, let's select the Shamico module, tap on Shamico and install it. Once that is done, go back, again tap on install from storage. Now you have to flash the LS4 framework. This is the LSPost app, flash it as well. It will take a few seconds. Once that is done, flash the Play Integrity Fix module, which is here, tap on OK. And now you have to flash the Zygisk Assistant module as well. So Zygisk Assistant, this is the module, tap on OK. And now you have to flash the Tricky Store. This is quite an important module in this regard. So flash the Tricky Store module as well. Once that is done, install a root supported file manager app. As of now, I'm using the solid file manager app, and then launch the app, and then let me show you once again how to get this job done. Let me first remove this app from my phone so that we'll be able to identify the entire process of installation and using of this app. So let's install the app from Play Store, which will take just a few seconds. In the meantime, now that you have flashed all these modules on your phone, one more thing is required. In case of Magisk, you will also have to enable Zygisk. So go to the Magisk homepage, tap on the settings icon, then enable the toggle next to Zygisk. It will now ask you to restart your phone. So we will also do a restart now. Let's just wait for the app to be installed. And the app is now installed, so you will now do a restart. For that, simply launch the Magisk app and tap on the reboot icon, select reboot, and your phone will now reboot to the OS. So in the meantime, if you talk about flashing the LSPost framework, do keep in mind that the LSPost has now been archived. So till Android 14, you may use the official build, but beginning with Android 15, you will have to use the mod version. I have shared the mod version for LSPOS Android 15 as well. You could download the Android 15 build from here. Let me show you. This is specific for the Android 15 build, and for the rest of the phone, you may download the original Android 14 as well. This is their GitHub download link. Let me show you. This is the official version. Always make sure to download the Zygisk version and not the Riru version. So get hold of the Zygisk version and flash them. With that said, we have flashed all the modules. Zygisk is also enabled, as you could see, showing as yes. If you go to the module section, we now have all the modules up and running. So now launch the File Manager app on your phone. Then let's skip the initial setup process. Now give it the storage access. So let's do that as well, and also enable the auto rotate option on your phone. Once that is done, download the Keybox XML file. For that, you could contact me via the guide or YouTube videos comment section, and I'll mail you the Keybox XML file. Once you have got the Keybox XML file, you will then have to transfer this file onto your phone. And now let me show you the location of this file. So what you have to do is auto rotate your phone. Just give me a second. Once that is done, you could see as of now both are showing as my files. So let's keep the first as the internal storage, whereas the second section should be kept as the root directory. So tap on the hamburger menu and select root. You will get a magic request. Tap on grant, and as you could see, this is the root directory and this is the internal storage. So in the root directory, you have to go to data, ADB, and tricky store. This is the location. Now you will have to transfer the Keybox XML file inside this tricky store folder. So let me access the file download folder, and this is the Keybox XML file. Copy it from here and paste the file here. You'll get a prompt, select new, and the file has been placed and pasted. As you could see, the pasting is now complete, so we could now verify the result as well. Once that is done, it's highly recommended that you restart your phone once again. So let me do that via Magisk app itself. Launch Magisk and hit the reboot icon, and your phone will now reboot to the OS. And this time around, you should now pass all the three tests, including the strong integrity. For testing out, we are using the Play Integrity API checker, as I've told you before, but there also exists quite a few third-party apps and even the Play Store. You may even check using the Play Store as well, but for the ease of convenience, I'm using the Play Integrity API checker app. So with that said, let's wait for a few seconds for a phone to boot to the OS, and then we'll verify the result as well. It should just take a few more seconds. And with this, we are now inside the OS. So make sure you are currently online and have a Wi-Fi connection. If that's well and good, launch the Integrity Checker app and tap on check. It will take a couple of seconds. And let's now verify the result. As you could see, we are now passing all the three tests, including a strong integrity, which was a major requirement. So again, I'm repeating, at the time of recording this video, this file is unrevoked and has not been revoked, but that might not be the case in the subsequent month. So until and unless this file gets revoked, you are free to use this file. Simply drop in the your comments in this guide. Again, I'm repeating, make sure that you don't use your professional or workspace email, because the email will be visible in the comment section. You may use a temporary email as well, and I will mail you the Keybox XML file. You may simply use this file and get the job done. So guys, on that note, I round up this video. Okay, one more thing. There also exists a method using which you can pass the strong integrity test even without using any Keybox XML file. So in the near future, if the file gets revoked, then you may easily use this guide to pass the strong integrity test even without using the XML file. This is quite an interesting guide and a video. I will highly recommend you to go through this guide once as well. And on that note, I round up this video. If you have any queries, do let me know in the comment section. And thanks a lot for watching.